Hello, everybody. Welcome to the first ever Spotlight Etobicoke. We are live. My name is Heather Urban, and I'm the Communications and Development Manager at Arts Etobicoke. And I want to thank you for coming and tuning in tonight for our Spotlight Etobicoke. We're a local charitable organization. We're one of Toronto's local arts service organizations, and we exist to create high-quality arts experiences for the people of Etobicoke. We do this through artist support and development, and bringing those artists together with our community members to create compelling and engaging experiences for the people of Etobicoke that help to build our community through the arts. So thank you for tuning in, and thank you for supporting local artists. Tonight couldn't happen without the support of our funders and sponsors. So I'd like to say a huge thank you to the TELUS Friendly Future Foundation, the City of Toronto, and the Ontario Arts Council. I'd also like to say a huge thank you to a brand new food sponsor, Kitchen Hub Food Hall. Kitchen Hub has provided all of our performers tonight with food to fuel them for their performances. They also have a deal for you. So they're offering 15% off delivery tonight. All you have to do is go to DoorDash, search Kitchen Hub Food Hall, use promo code ARTSETOPICOKE, all one word, all capital letters, and then sit back, enjoy some delicious local food while you watch amazing local talent. They are a fantastic local delivery company, Kitchen Hub Virtual Food Hall, Toronto's top restaurants under one roof. So I'm gonna enjoy an incredible super salad and some fried chicken while I watch our amazing local performers. Thank you, Kitchen Hub Food Hall. Don't forget to get your orders in. 15% off delivery, first 100 orders only. So order now. I'm now gonna turn it over to our local Ward 1 counselor, Michael Ford, who's gonna introduce tonight's first performer. Thanks for tuning in and enjoy the show.
Good morning, everyone. Michael Ford here, the city counselor for Etobicoke North here in the city of Toronto. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you all to the first ever Spotlight Etobicoke. Of course, because of COVID-19, it is happening a little differently than otherwise it would. Hence, I'm coming to you virtually from my own home. This incredible event will feature 13 talented local artists with a wide range of talents. I'm truly looking forward to their great performances. Now, more than ever, the arts are playing such an important role in our city and our communities in keeping us connected while we stay at home and do our part to flatten the curve. With that being said, I'd like to welcome our first performers for today, and from my own ward too in North Etobicoke, Auntie B and Friends. Have a great day, everyone, and stay safe.
Having some fun.
Hey, my groovy friends, hey, welcome to the small, neat village where people sing and dance. Are you ready to have a groovy time with Artsy Topico and Spotlighty Topico? Oh my goodness, oh, I'm so excited about the show. I forgot about my sugary treat. Oh, my groovy friends, my favorite sugary treat is pecan chocolate swirl. I'm talking 3 scoops of ice cream on a waffle cone. Pecan chocolate swirl. Oh, yeah.
And my favorite snack is peanut butter jelly sandwiches.
Khadija, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches?
Yep. Peanut butter jelly sandwiches.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, first you take the peanuts and you crunch them. You crunch them.
Oh, first you take the peanuts and you crunch them. You crunch them for the peanut. Peanut butter
and jelly.
Peanut butter
and jelly. Then you take the greens and you squish them. You squish squish them. Oh, then you take the grapes and you squish them. You squish them for the peanut butter.
And jelly.
Peanut butter.
And jelly. Then you take the bread and spread it. You spread it.
Oh, then you take the bread and you spread it. You spread it for the peanut butter.
And jelly.
Peanut butter.
And jelly. Then you take the sandwich and you eat it.
Oh, then you take the sandwich and you eat it. You eat it cause it's good peanut butter.
And jelly.
Good peanut butter.
And jelly. Sorry. Oh, God.
Peanut butter and jelly. Well, thank you so much, Khadijah, for sharing your favorite treat with us all.
See you later, Auntie B.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Oh. And stay groovy.
Oh, my goodness. Isn't Khadijah just groovy? Oh, friends, you know what? This reminds me of another song that I like. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It's true. It's true. One of my favorite songs is Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. And do you know why? Well, okay, I'll tell you. It's because Auntie Bee believes that everybody has a star inside of them. It's true, it's true. Do you want to sing it with me? It goes, twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Now, my groovy friends, I know we're in the house right now, and we have to practice social distancing. Oh, but don't you get discouraged, my groovy friends. All you have to do is stand up straight, stick your heart out, stay groovy, of course, and take the risk. Take the risk and use your imagination. Take the risk and read a groovy book. Maybe color a picture. But no matter what you do, my friends, take the risk and be kind. And now, don't you go anywhere, my groovy friends. We have a lot of groovy performers for you tonight. It's true, it's true. We do, we do. So stay tuned, my friends. Stay with us. You can sing, you can dance, you can even laugh. Enjoy the show, my groovy friends. And of course, stay kind, stay safe, and stay groovy.
Hi, I'm Adina. I'm a singer-songwriter. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight, and thank you so much for Arts Etobicoke for having me and for everyone involved. I'm going to share three original songs with you tonight. First one is an interlude. It's called Still Blue. Nothing quite feels like it did. I wanna be a little kid again. Wanna wake up in the house I grew up in. I still cry when I drive by. Is that a sin? And every time we are alone, I think I'd like to build a home with you. And I know that there's no rush, I know it's too soon.
But I'll admit the thought still exists of a promise set in stone. You and I grew up in a family divide, still blue and tired, running from the things we had inside.
Next, I'd like to play one that's a little more upbeat. It's called Open Wide. Grab my pick here. Some things change, but a lot stays. So this last one I want to play, I just have to tune for, so give me a moment here while I tell you about it. It's called Down the Hall, and I actually recently released it on, well, basically anywhere you listen to music. Spotify, Apple Music, the like. And yeah, so if you just look up Adina V, you'll find me if it's something you want to listen to. It's a song about missing people in times like these, but at the same time knowing that we're still together but apart. So yeah, this is Down the Hall.
Thank you for joining us, and thank you to all the wonderful performers who are here with us tonight. My name is Wendy Radin, and I'm the Executive Director at Arts Etobicoke. These times are bringing us together in wonderful and unusual ways, and we're thrilled to have you with us. Here at Arts Etobicoke, we strive to bring you meaningful and impactful arts programming, and we're continuing to do that during this time through the event that you're at right now, as well as through online art classes, an interactive digital gallery, artist studio tours, and arts demos. Now, more than ever, we know we need to support our local artists, and we need to continue to safely connect with our community. Normally, I would invite you down to our gallery space in Islington Village, but for now, we'll invite you to our virtual space, which is at artsetobicoke.com, where you can continue to connect with us and connect with our arts community, explore our free online art programming, and sign up for our newsletter if you'd like to learn more. But for now, we want you to sit back and enjoy. I have the honor to introduce to you a talented young acoustic guitarist, Dalen Henschel.
How's it going, everyone? My name's Dalen. I'm going to be doing some stuff on the acoustic guitar. I hope you're all well. First song I'm going to play is a cover of a tune by Michael Jackson called Billie Jean. And I hope you all enjoy, and I hope the audio is okay. Thank you. right, thanks everyone. Like I said, I hope the audio is okay. I'm a bit of a useless person when it comes to troubleshooting technology here, so I hope everything's going good. Anyway, I want to say a big thank you to Arts Etobicoke for having this event and helping to keep music alive during this crazy time. And a big thank you to John and everyone over there. I'm really grateful for this gig. So I've had lots of time during this quarantine to work on music. And the other day I was playing some guitar out back on my deck, and I wrote this little song. And I performed it for my neighbor's dog, and he really seemed to enjoy it, so I hope you like it too. Also, a shout out to everyone from Humber performing tonight, and all the performances in general. There's some amazing music coming up, and I know a lot of the performers are from Humber, which is where I also go to school, and I'm really looking forward to getting back there whenever that's a possibility. So anyway, here's a song I wrote called Papaya Shores. That was it. Thanks everyone, hope you enjoyed that. Kind of a high concept piece of music there. I'm not sure if you understood the artistic themes and elements I was trying to convey there. No, I'm kidding. Okay, here it is for real. Papaya Shores. Thank you. thanks so much, everyone. Stay tuned for some amazing performances. Have a good one.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Dave Toms, and I just wanted to say thank you to Arts Etobicoke for such a great event this evening. I also went to Vince Massey High School quite a few years ago and just finished my first year at Humber College as a jazz piano major in the Bachelor of Music degree program. And great to see a lot of my colleagues and the other artists this evening. I'm going to do a couple of songs, one of them a great song by Ray Charles called Georgia. Another song called Hymn to Freedom that Oscar Peterson and Doug Riley and many others have performed. So thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Hello, my name is Ian Dodds, and I'm the Communications and Development Coordinator at Arts Etobicoke. Part of what Arts Etobicoke does is arts advocacy. We work with other community arts organizations to advocate for community arts funding and opportunities for artists. It might be hard to see it right now, but we want you to know that we're here working for you, our community, and we'll continue to advocate for community arts funding and opportunities for artists. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce to you our next act, Leah Kay.
Hi, I'm Leah Kay, and this is my guitarist, Jesse Martell. I want to thank Arts Etobicoke for putting on this wonderful event and supporting local artists in this difficult time. I hope you're all safe and healthy. If you like what you hear, you can check me out on Facebook and SoundCloud and YouTube. I'll be performing on Radio Humber's Band Together event at 5 p.m. tomorrow, and you can check that out at radio.humber.ca. So the song we're going to play right now is an original of mine, and it's about overcoming adversity, and it's called How to Live a Life. Thanks for listening. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hard about it. No, you can't find answers in the way you lost them. No, well, it's safety first and joy is secondary. 'Cause life is hard, the world is scary. I know it's getting worse, but baby, it's mad. Stationary is the best defense from down and out, and who wants to be there? No, a dream can easily be lost and broken, so hold it close, don't be outspoken. It's not worth the pain, but it's in itself. Yeah, in one All right, and this last song that I'm going to play for you is another original of mine, and it's called Something to Say. So much, everyone. Have a good night.
Hello, everyone. My apologies about that misstep. I made a silly mistake. I forgot to unmute my mic. It's all good, though. I'm going to be playing a few songs. My name is Nick Brugget. I'm a first-year student in the Bachelor of Music program at Humber College, studying jazz trombone. I also play piano, and I'm going to be playing a few songs. I pre-recorded some piano, so I will be doing that for you today. I hope you guys enjoy. I'm going to start with the tune called On a Misty Night by Tad Dameron.
Thank you.
thanks so much. That was my first tune. That was entitled On a Misty Night by Tad Dameron. I'm going to play one more tune for everyone. This one is entitled Dance of Wine and Roses by Henry Mancini. Hope you guys enjoy it. Make sure to stick around. There's a whole bunch of really good acts coming up soon. If you want to check out any more music that I do, my links are right down there where I'm pointing. Thank you all so much. Hope you have a great day.
Greetings from Etobicoke Center. I'm Deputy Mayor Stephen Holliday, your member of council for Ward 2. COVID-19 has changed our lives in unimaginable ways. While we stay indoors to social distance and keep our bodies healthy, there is no more important time than ever to celebrate our talented arts community here in Etobicoke. Whether you're an accomplished artist, an aspiring artist, a creative type, or someone just enjoying taking it all in. Experiencing visual arts, music, and motion feeds the mind and heals the soul as we make it through these challenging times. Our local art scene is alive and strong and is overcoming the challenges of COVID-19. Spotlight Etobicoke is part of the medicine we need to fight this pandemic. I want to welcome our next performer, a singer and songwriter who plays acoustic guitar, electric guitar, mandolin, and piano. Here's Alan Kulka.
Special to you, like you're special to me. I will brave a storm for you. Will you brave a storm for me? I would take the pain for you. Will you take the pain for me? Am I hero to you, like you're hero to me? Oh, so special. You are to me. So special to me. Yeah. You. Special to you, like you're special to me. I will fight the world for you. Will you fight the world for me? I will fly away with you. Will you fly away with me? Am I an angel to you, like you're an angel to me? Oh, so You are to me, so special to me, yeah, yeah. To you, like you're special to me. If I wrote a song for you, would you sing along with me? So special, you
so much. My name is Alan Kulka, and super happy to be here. Really thankful for everyone who's tuning in, and for Arts Etobicoke for the wonderful opportunity that you've provided us artists with to bring a little bit of light into these very strange times. This next song, so I should just mention that was my song special, which you can find on Spotify and any other streaming platform that you use. It's the only song that I have out right now, but I have a couple things in the works as a follow-up single, and so I'm excited to release that in the very near future. So just be sure to follow me on socials if you want to follow me on my journey. It's at @itsalankulka. This next song is a very special song to me. I wrote it while I was in London, actually, a few years back. And it's just kind of like a reminder to seize the day. And we're often putting things off in our lives, whatever it is we want to accomplish. And so it's a good reminder for myself even to make the change today. And there's no better time than now to do the things that you want to do in life. So this is called Now's the Time.
When you're lonely, don't feel in a rush. Let your heartbeat be the only compass that you trust. Now is the time to be living the dreams you dream. Chase them religiously when no one else. Take me there.
thank you so much one more time to everyone for tuning in. This is gonna be my last little ditty for you all. It's actually just an excerpt of a song I wrote a few weeks back. This is my most recent thing that I've written. It's pretty self-explanatory. I just feel like I could really use a hug right now. I don't know about anyone else, but if you can, this one's for you. This one's called Hug.
Cooped up all day, tick-tock in my brain, looking for that next job, because these bills ain't gonna pay themselves. Hey, who can relate? Being busy, doing a whole lot of nothing, social distancing from 6 feet. Quarantine, finding it hard to believe this might be reality for a couple of weeks. Speaking of a couple, shout-outs to everyone in love, and I hope when this is over, we'll be closer than before, yeah. I wanna give you all a hug. I wish that I could give you all a hug, yeah, yeah. Even though we're far apart, I'm feeling closer to your heart, yeah. I've been affected, the only bug I got is love, yeah. Can we give you all the hug? Ooh, 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 ooh. I wanna give you all the hug. Thank you again so much to Spotlight Etobicoke, Bart Etobicoke, and to all the sponsors, and to everyone who tuned in. Please enjoy the rest of the evening. And again, like I said, if you want to follow me on my journey, you can find me at it's Alan Kulka, ITSALANKULKA on all social media. Enjoy the rest of the show and be safe. Thank you. Much love.
Hey everyone, my name is Dean Venerus. Thank you so much to everyone for tuning in. Thanks to Arts Etobicoke for having me. I play vibraphone and I'm going to start off with an original composition of mine that I wrote last August entitled Side Facing House. Thank you. Studio audience, my family and my dog Ruby for watching me at home here. I'm gonna move on with a composition by Duke Ellington called Isfahan, a really beautiful ballad.
Thank you.
thanks so much, everyone. I'm going to finish up with a blues by Charlie Parker I really like, called Cheryl.
Hello everyone, my name is Akshata Naik and I'm the Programs and Gallery Manager at Arts Etobicoke. I'm very proud to be working at Arts Etobicoke because we are able to support the local artists by providing them a platform to showcase their art in the gallery setting, but also online on diverse platforms during a pandemic. We also provide with different artist professional development workshops, and one such talent that came out of this program is our next performer, Ian Todd, who's going to perform some hard-hitting tongue twister poetry slam tonight. So stay tuned and cheer on for Ian Todd. Thank you.
Hey everyone, my name is Sterling Dillinger. Thank you, Arts Etobicoke, for having me on today as part of our show. I don't often get to perform in my living room, and when I do, it usually means that my neighbor's going to be knocking on the walls, yelling, be quiet, knocking on the door, calling the police, all that kind of stuff. But today, we get to do a live show for the next 5 minutes, so I'm going to be entertaining you guys. I've had a long history of dating vegetarians, and I don't know why I keep coming back to them, but I had the vegetarian, the vegan, the other vegan, the pescatarian, the meatitarian. That was a girl who only ate hamburgers the entire way through our relationship. Was not great. So through all that crazy journey, I learned a lot about vegetarians and the different lifestyle and different food choices, and like learn to grow and love that kind of stuff. So I just want to share a little bit about that with you guys today. Dating a vegetarian can be tough on a hungry man. She is a herbivore and he is a carnivore, a meat-beating, chainsaw-swinging, bearded, flesh-bound, leveraged man with eating glasses who solely survives on the salty, meaty, bacony, greasy insides, outsides, a cute little farm house in the roadside roads of Stouffville. Dinner dates were coupled with long walks on the beach in those first few weeks. The taste of beef on my teeth were the hearts of the snacks on plums and leeks. Thinking about the wonderful creations I made from food, like the refreshing meat shake. All I needed was a blender filled with 2 pounds of smoked-back bacon, half a cup of Swiss Chalet protein powder gravy, 4 raw eggs unshelled, chicken gizzards in the top shelf, and pet store lizards for the added boost of health. Add in a hefty scoop or two of your favorite ice cream to cool down, fluff, whip, and mix my foodies fat pay to finally make another treat I call the meat shake. But there's no room in my dietary prison cell for that anymore. I've become the healthy omnivore. You know the kind who eats on both sides of the fence? Together, her and I share green leaf lettuce atop with cashews, cranberries, goat cheese, cucumbers, avocados, and tomatoes in a moonlit backdrop surrounded by candles and quiet music. Then, for second dinner, I'd sneak back downstairs and microwave cans of spam while browsing my junk email folder. I'm reading spam while eating spam. But at least you can eat animal crackers. As long as the box they come in doesn't resemble a petting zoo, I put on my best elephant shoes and go celery stocking to her sometimes just to make sure she doesn't eat any baby carrots. I tell her, baby, even they have worried parents. I now find myself yelling at strangers and pimps that fur is murder. And I'm gonna strawberry you alive. Because I have become an animal rights activist, saving penguins, becoming bowling pins, and stopping baby seals from overdosing at clubs. And every last effort is worth to see a smile slip across her face. She's been putting caterpillars and cocoons, secreting her food every time I have it. Every time. Oh my God, I'm getting tripped up on it. Every time she enters the room, I have a stomach full of butterflies. She must be putting caterpillars and cocoons, secreting my food, because every time she enters the room, I have a stomach full of butterflies. Oh my goodness, I'm getting trapped on my own lines over here. Every day, she gives me a clean bill of health and two scoops of her razor. After too long in the shower together, her and I have razor hands that fit into the grooves of either like 180-gram vinyl and needles. Man, playing the symphony of sheet music set to her laugh lines, and I hope the chorus keeps on repeating that. This scrape is mine. This scrape is mine. So I'll thank every last giving a tofurkey she serves me to finally tell the world that dating a vegetarian can transform a hungry man. Thanks so much. It's very strange to be in your own space, because when you wait for that little round of applause or whatever it might be, or the whistle or the boo get off stage, you don't hear it. The only applause I'm hearing these days are the ones for the frontline workers, which takes me into my next piece, something I wrote for them just recently, the real heroes of what's going on today. To all the frontline workers, thank you. This was totally optional, but you turned into something possible. You probably earned more than your fair share of popsicles. That idea is laughable. You're thinking it's comical. You didn't know it was probable or solvable, but you felt unstoppable in lending a hand to tackle the obstacles. You're responsible. When people said that job was impossible, implausible, improbable, illogical, you showed them you're unbelievably dedicated, never stoppable, never missed a beat or inexhaustible. The perfect candidate who is totally optimal. Sometimes you may even get philosophical, like, what does it even really mean to save a life? And you were so logical, seeing what's optical, and wishing you were somewhere tropical, but you are here, and to me, as symbolical. With a chronicle of the work you've done to overcome each obstacle to our frontliners, there's only one word to describe you. Phenomenal. These workers make up the fabric of a tapestry so wide it covers the globe, making this group right here into the coziest of blankets. Spreading from corner to corner, you make this a comfortable place to be. And if you want to help the community, you have to involve the community. You took action where others couldn't, wouldn't, and didn't, providing an invaluable service for which we are forever grateful. Each one of you brings your own flavor to this melting pot. Calmness, laughter, friendship, and all the hand sanitizer we could ever want, which we could really use some more of that, by the way. Together, you were all creating a culture that I'm proud to be surrounded by. And if one of you died choking on a gummy bear, I'd tell everyone you were killed by a bear, just because I want people to think you are as cool as I know you are. So I ask you, what are you using your heart for? And what are you making your art for? Are you are all remaining in these roles to conceive, believe, and achieve, so you can build something better to give back one day. Because you are not in it for the income, just the outcome. This has nourished you, helped you flourish, pursue you to purpose, encouraged and asserted you. So again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. And thank you, Arts Etobicoke, for having me. My name is Sterling Dillinger. Peace.
Hello, good evening. My name is Elizabeth Gilarovich, and I am a vocalist and pianist. I currently study in Etobicoke School of the Arts High School in the musical theater program, and I'm in grade 10. Tonight, I would like to perform a piano piece called The Lark, which was composed by and description by Balakirev. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. It was a pleasure to perform for you, and enjoy the rest of the concert. Bye. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Kshama Patel, and I'm the operations manager at Arts Etobicoke. I just want to talk quickly about the dedication of our volunteers. To see someone give up their time and create meaningful experiences for and with their neighbors and their community is a true show of the importance of the programs that we do. If we were judged on our volunteers, Arts Etobicoke is the most successful organization around. We're lifted up by their expertise, their generosity, and their creativity. So a big shout out to all our volunteers. And we're welcoming new volunteers all the time, so please check out our website for more info. And now, on to the Del Crom Smooth Jazz.
Hi there! I'm Andrew.
And I'm Nina.
And we are Del Crom Smooth Jazz.
After we retired, we decided to learn how to play music. And we had so much fun that we started performing together in locally and then internationally everywhere we traveled.
That's wonderful. Now, our first piece is one that everyone knows. It's called Don't Know Why by Jesse Harris and made really, really popular by Nora Jones. After that, we'll do a Latin one, Cuban songwriter Osvaldo Ferrez. He gave us the song called Quizás, Quizás, Quizás. So let's start with Nora Jones.
Thank you.
And then we move on to something a little more Latin. Quizás, quizás, quizás. This was a great experience, and you stick around to hear the other artists. They were excellent. If you want to follow us, just go to Facebook and you can look for Delcrom Smooth Jazz, and you'll find us. Thanks.
Thanks. Good night, everyone.
Hi everyone, my name is Jessica Soule. I am a country singer, artist, songwriter. I just finished up my last year at Humber College in Etobicoke, and while I was doing my fourth year, I had the opportunity to record an EP I'm releasing next month, but I thought I would play you guys a few tunes off of the EP. So this first one is called Fine Line. Between love and wanting you to save me, between a good idea and going crazy. Right now, it's hard for me to tell if we know what we found. So we tell the bartender. Tell me your name and your story over something top 40. I could just make out what you said. And there's something so easy about the way that I feel that it's going straight to my head. Now I'm picturing you and I'm picturing me and I'm picturing all of the things in between. But there's a fine line between you and the whiskey. So
is called Fine Line, and it will be featured on my upcoming EP. Stay tuned, it'll be out June 19th. And this next one is called Here for the Long Run. It's the title track to the EP, but before I start, I just wanted to say a huge thank you to Arts Etobicoke for putting this showcase on, and thank you for having me. I'm having a great time, and there's so many great artists, a lot of Humber students and Humber grads, so hey to all my friends. So yeah, this one's called Here for the Long Run. I hope you guys enjoy it. It's available on Spotify and wherever else you get your music, and I'm super excited to say that it was released and picked up by radio, so we're super excited about that. I hope that y'all like it. Turn up the radio, sing loud to forget the way your voice sounds. It's in my head, all the things that you said. So I check my heart and the heart rate goes up before I do something stupid like turn back around. I need to be on my own right now. It's a simple decision, no time to think twice before I do something stupid like change my own mind. I really is there room for one? I'll be here for the long run. Way, so I'll let you take all the blame, 'cause I'm not I'll be here for the long run. I'll be here for the long run. So once again, thank you so much. And like I said, I do have some music coming out. I have a new song coming out next week. And then in June, I have my EP. So if you want more updates about that, make sure to follow along. You can find all of my information at the bottom of the screen. But thanks, Arts Etobicoke, and thanks everyone for tuning in. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show and have a great evening.
My name is Magdiel Espinal, and I work as a Community Research Coordinator at Arts Etobicoke. As an organization that serves the community, Arts Etobicoke has programs for everyone, from art classes to gallery openings. All age groups are involved in our efforts to make art more accessible in Etobicoke. We're currently working on a project called Digital Strategies, which goal is to find out what art and cultural practices our community engages with, what would you like to see more of, and how we can incorporate all that in our programming. To keep up with our programs and events, sign up for our newsletter on our website and follow our social media accounts. Now, without further delay, I'll introduce you to our last performance of the night, House on 10th Street.
And yeah.
Hi, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed of Arts Etobicoke's first ever Spotlight concert series just as much as we have. We are House on 10th Street, and we're going to be playing some songs for you today.
My roommates and I are going to play three songs. The first one is called Un Pato, and it's a bossa nova.
Empezó a cantar.
so you won't permit me. Now I'm so amazing. I loved and I lost, but that's not what I see. Look what I found. Ain't no need for searching. And all that I see, thank you. Rats, rats, thank you. Rats, rats, thank you. Rats. I'm so fucking good.
Thanks so much, Arts Etobicoke, for hosting this awesome event, and thank you for tuning in.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for tuning in to our first ever Spotlight Etobicoke livestream event. I hope you enjoyed those amazing performances from all our talented local artists. My name is John Del Rosario and I'm the Special Projects Manager at Arts Etobicoke. Just wanted to take this time to thank all our sponsors and funders, including the TELUS Friendly Future Foundation, the City of Toronto, Ontario Arts Council, and tonight's food sponsors, The Kitchen Hub. A special thanks goes out to Ward 1 Councillor Michael Ford and Deputy Mayor Stephen Holliday for their continued support of our programming. I'd also like to thank Jason Dole, our stage director, and the Stage 10 team for helping us put together this incredible online talent showcase. I have the pleasure and honor to work with many amazing artists like you saw tonight, but none of this would be possible without the support of our community. Arts Etobicoke recognizes the importance of community building and community outreach, especially during times like these. So let's keep creating and working together to share the positive impact of arts and culture in our communities. Thank you again so much for tuning in. Be safe and take care. Good night.